1コートで男子ダブルス、モハマド・アッサン選手、ヘンドラ・セティアワン選手、インドネシア、フン・ティエンホー選手、タン・ウィーキョン選手、マレーシアを行います。この試合の主審はリン・マウンド、アメリカ。サービスジャッジはアントニウス・ランドリー、フランスです。
The next match on court 1 is a men's doubles quarterfinals between Mohammad Ahsan, Hendra Setiawan of Indonesia and Thien Hoon, Wee Kyontan of Malaysia. The umpire is Lin Mound of USA, and the service judge is Antonius Landry of France.
So our MC, having announced the players onto court for the last of our quarterfinals this afternoon, the men's doubles, the defending champions, the world champions, Mohammad Ahsan and Hendra Setiawan, up against the number 7 seeds from Malaysia, Hoon Thien Hao and Tan Wee Kiong. The Malaysians in the yellow shirts, the defending champions from Indonesia in the all-black kit. So for Hendra Setiawan, there he is, the man nearest to us. Two finals here at the Japan Open, and two titles with two different partners, because apart from winning last year with his partner of today, he won in 2009 with Marcus Kido. For his partner, well, he's been in three finals because he's twice reached the final with his former partner, Abona Septano. Now there they are, the defending champions, the world champions, Mohammad Ahsan on the left as we look at them, 26-year-old from Palembang in South Sumatra, and his partner Hendra Setiawan from the ancient city of Malang in East Java, 29 years of age. And of course, Hendra Setiawan is a former Olympic champion as well. They are the number one in the world, and therefore they're the number one seeds. And both of their matches so far have gone the full distance against the young Chinese pair of Liu Cheng and Kang Jun, lost the opening game, and then against the home pair of Kimura and Sonoda, once again losing the opening game before coming back to win in three. So to the Malaysians, the number 7 seeds, number 7 in the world, that's the highest they've ever been. They've been 7 before, but that's never higher. 7-7 is not such a good win-loss record for the year. 7 tournaments, the best they've had so far in individual competition was a semi-final at the German Grand Prix Gold. Now, like their opponents, they've been stretched the full distance. In fact, in the opening match, opening round against Li Chung-hei and Chen Yong-lung, well, they had to save two match points in that deciding game before eventually winning 24-22 against Jongjit and Puang Puapet of Thailand in yesterday's match. That was much more straightforward. So the Malaysians, well, fully involved in the Thomas Cup campaign, but not necessarily playing together.
Players, get ready.
Partnerships were swapped about, and a stroke of genius as far as selections were concerned for Malaysia. Saw them all the way through to the final. Lin Mun from United States of America is our umpire for this one. Antonius Alandre from France, our service judge. There she is. Well, this will be the fourth meeting between these two pairs. The previous three meetings, it's Mohammad Ahsan and Hendra Setiawan who in fact won the last two. It was only the first time they met when the Malaysians won. And given that it was only the second tournament that the Indonesian pair had played together, which was at the French Open of 2012. Not altogether surprising in such early stages of their partnership.
Right, Mohammad Ahsan, Hendra Setiawan, Indonesia. On my left, Thien Hao Hoon, Wei Kiong Thien, Malaysia. Wei Kiong Thien to serve to Mohammad Ahsan. Love all. Play.
So the Malaysian pair of Hoon Thien Hao and Tan Wei Kiong, number seven seeds, far side of the court.
One love.
Well, they will know from seeing their opponents in the early stages of this tournament that the world champions have been struggling with their form. And they will believe they have good chances.
Service over.
12 months ago, this Indonesian pair beat Chai Biao and Hong Wei in the final. Incidentally, that Chinese pair lost first round this year. Oof, missed it. Overdone it.
3-1.
No serve is short.
2-3.
Only one title to their names, the Malaysian pair.
Service over.
That
four,
was the
two.
Macau Grand Prix last year. They've been in a Super Series tournament final as well. That was the China Premier Super Series at the end of last year.
5-2. Service over, 3-5.
That's a good smash from Hendra Setiawan.
4-5.
Only three previous individual tournaments this year for the world champions. Won the All England Championships in March. It's going wide. There's a very good reason why they both have not been playing so many tournaments, because they've both become fathers for the first time. Sleepless nights and duties of fatherhood.
6-5. Service over, 6-6.
In fact, this man has got twin babies. Akin to Roger Federer, who's just had twin boys after his
Service
twin girls.
7-6.
Nobody wanting to lift the shuttle at the moment.
8-6.
That's understandable. Doubles is all about the attacking play, so why would you want to give away that opportunity by lifting the shuttle? Yeah, well worked by Tan Wei Kiong.
Service over. 7-8.
Now, we see this time and time again with men's doubles. Very, very short rallies.
Service over, 8-9.
Played 3 minutes
nine.
So far. And we're already at 8-9.
Service over, 10-8. 11-8.
Well, to the mid-game interval, the defending champions with a three-point advantage. 4 minutes by my clock in the first half of that game. And some people in badminton want to make the game shorter. Well, 4 minutes for half a game. Yeah. We don't want it any shorter than this. In fact, we want it longer.
One,
amazing coaches.
Seconds.
One, Chia Chang. And Jeremy Gann, I think that is.
11-8. Play.
Oh.
12-8.
Well. When Mohammad, Ahsan and Hendra Setiawan won the World Championship last year, in my opinion, Mohammad, Ahsan was the best player on court. So quick and so positive. Oh, that's misjudgment from Setiawan.
Service over.
Deliberately left that, but that landed
9-12.
In.
12.
Yeah, good call, line judge.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Oh, between the legs. Oh my goodness me. The trickery.
Service over. 13-9.
Yeah, they still won the point.
Service over. 10-13.
Oh, well taken. Well, there only seemed to be half an opportunity there for Mohammad Ahsan.
14-10.
Very, very little movement of the racket head, and he still put that away so swiftly. Matches between these two pairs, all three of them have been won or lost in two straight games. And the world champions
16,
at the moment
10.
Seem to be winning at a canter. Double hit.
11-16.
Well spotted by the umpire. Yeah. There's no doubting this
16.
Man's racket skills, Hoon Thien. 27-year-old from Kuala Lumpur. In fact, former world junior champion with Tambun Kiong. Oh. It was back in 2004.
Oh. Oh. Service over, 17-12.
Oh, good return. Yeah, look at those racket skills again.
Service over.
If only he was in better
13,
physical condition.
18.
Oh.
Service over, 19-13.
Now we're up to 9 minutes now. Slightly longer rally.
14-19. 15-19. Attention to shuttle for me, please. It's over, 20. Game point, 15.
So after 10 minutes of play, we've already arrived at game points.
Service over, 16-20.
Actually, that's an exaggeration. We had a minute's timeout, didn't we, in the middle of the game, in the big game interval, so it was only 9 minutes of play. Much better rally.
Game.
And a good change of
first
pace at the end.
First game won by Mohammad Ahsan, Hendra Setiawan, 21-16.
21-16 confirms the umpire. There we go. We have stretched into the 11-minute mark. In the opening game, 21-16. Oh, Malaysians are going to have to up the game in the second hit. They want to extend this quarterfinal.
Second game, love all.
So the umpire calls for the start of the second game.
One love.
And the defending champions starting the second as they finish the first, looking very sharp indeed. And there you are.
Service over. One.
That's the curse of the commentator. It looks so easy, doesn't he?
It's over.
Sees
two,
the gaps.
One.
No dramatics. Stands in the right place at the right time, intercepts and just guides the shuttle into the open space.
Service over, 2-2.
Taken.
3-2.
And I think the Malaysian pair have got to really work the rallies to get the net player involved. I don't think they'll hit many winners from the back of the court. It's all about the control of the front court area.
Four, two.
the judgment deliberately left that, did Mohammad Ahsan. Yeah, really long.
Service over, 5-3. 6-3.
Serve is just short.
It's over.
Seemed to be an agonizing wait before the line judge made the call. It's going wide.
5-7.
Oh.
6-7.
Well, at least we're seeing longer rallies here in this second game. One suspects that a simple block there may have sufficed. We can all be wise after the event. Hendra Setiawan doesn't miss many of those.
6.
It's going wide.
Service over, 7.
Really got
8.
Into a flow at all so far this match. Get back level. And indeed, just ease into the lead. 6 of the last 7 points going to the defending champions. Oh, well taken.
10-8.
As I was saying earlier, he makes it look so easy. And I can assure you, controlling that shot was not easy at all.
11-8 interval.
So 11-8, having already taken the first. It was 3-7 down they were. 8 of 9 points. Perfect flick serve. Well, the match duration is not even 20 minutes yet.
For 1, 20
seconds. 2 minute timeouts.
For 1, 20 seconds.
We've had 2 1-minute timeouts.
11-8, play.
Now, just apologises, that was a mishit.
9-11.
Well,
11-all.
Setiawan just appealing to the umpire, thought that his opponent had touched that shuttle before it landed out. She says no. So we point to the Malaysians. Taken.
Service over.
Well, for years I've been singing 12, the praises 11. Of Hendra Setiawan's front court play, how he reads the game, how he always seems to be in the right place at the right time. But this young man, Mohammad Ahsan, is getting equally as good. Very, very sharp at the net indeed.
Service over, 12-all. It's over, 13-12.
Short, sharp rallies again.
15-all.
That is a brilliant interception.
16-15.
Tam Wee Kiong timing that to perfection. This is more like it. This is what we want to see. Well, disappointing end to an excellent rally. Anticipated.
He
got himself a bit tangled up, did Mohammad Ahsan.
The men's doubles,
18-16. Wow.
2-point advantage. Oof. Well, the big swing of the racket when you're at the net.
18.
I said a moment ago, he did that and his timing was perfect. That time his timing was off. And what a contrast. A winner to an error. Good flick serve.
All.
And once again, back level.
On court.
Well, I can tell you as we look at that again that the umpire telling Tam Wee Kiong, who wanted to go and have a word with the service judge, that he wasn't allowed to, and quite rightly so. Good umpiring. And that could be perceived as trying to intimidate one of the court officials by going to talk to them. Oh, that's well played from Hendra Setiawan.
19-18.
3 straight points to go into the lead, the defending champions. Four straight points.
20
to bring up two match points.
18.
Yeah, good return.
What on earth was
Ahsan thinking about there?
20.
Second time of asking. First match in the tournament so far. Won in 2 straight games by the defending champions, the world champions, Mohammad Ahsan and Hendra Setiawan. 21-16, 21-19
in
2 minutes under the 30-minute mark.
21-16, 21-19.
28 minutes. Four minutes of that was in timeouts. And this is the final rally. Look how eager they are to keep on the attack. They made things difficult for themselves in the early stages of that. Second game did the defending champions, 3-7 down at one stage. But it's not how you start, it's how you finish. There, confirmation of the score. And still on course to defend their title. Ahsan and Setiawan, the number one seeds. 21-16, 21-19. Hunters are out and the souvenir shuttles hit into the crowd. So they take leave of centre stage knowing that they will contest the semi-final tomorrow. So that concludes our five quarterfinals for this afternoon. It all started with a mixed doubles. What an excellent match it was, with the Olympic champions and defending champions here in Japan, Zhang Nang and Zhao Yunlei, eventually coming through 21-19 in the deciding game in a match lasting 1 minute over the hour mark. Then desperately disappointing in the women's doubles and the retirement of Miki and Yonemoto. Matsutomo and Takahashi, the number three seeds, were leading 7-3 when their opponents withdrew injured. Then we had women's singles and the Olympic champion Li Shuerei up against the European champion, the left-handed Carolina Marin. Fairly straightforward for the Olympic champion in two straight games. And what a men's singles we had. The home favourite, the number four seed, Kenichi Tago. Well, he was beaten finalist 12 months ago. This year, he needed three games to get past Vittinghus in the quarterfinal stage. What a thrill it was. An hour and 8 minutes. And as we've just seen in the men's doubles, the defending champions and world champions, Mohammad, Ahsan and Hendra, Setiawan. Just 28 minutes needed for that 21-16, 21-19 victory. So as I say, that concludes quarterfinals a day. We will be back with the semi-finals same time tomorrow. That's 12 noon local time. That's 0300 GMT from all of us in Tokyo. Until tomorrow, bye-bye.
Ha 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 ha